In this video, we're going to talk about how to make animated plots with Matplotlib and Python like this. So please stay tuned. In order to make animated plots with Matplotlib and Python, we need to import some packages, which you can see here, and we are going to use them later. And then we want to use a data frame. We want to use a CSV file in order to make a data frame, and we want to read data from that data frame. And the data frame is in the description below. I mean, the link of that data is in the description below. And you can see that here is the data. It has one column, which is X, and another column, which is Y. So as you can see, I'm reading this data. I'm using pandas.read.csv, and this is the path of that file on my computer. And I want to store the data frame in a variable, let's say, called df. And then we want to define two variables, let's say X, which is an empty list, and Y, which is again another empty list. And these two variables, I mean X and Y, are the X and Y of our plot, which we are going to add a lot of data, append a lot of data while we are updating the plot. So first of all, we need to create a figure and also an axis. So we simply type fig and ax, which stands for axis in my mind. So I simply type plt.subplots. And there it is. We have created figure and axis. Then we are going to plot something. So we simply type ax.plot. I mean, we want to plot something on our axis. So we want to plot something on our axis, which is X and Y. And as you can see, now our X and Y is empty. So the axis is going to be empty. But later, we are going to append lots of data to these two variables, I mean, X and Y. Then we want to use a counter in order to loop through every index, every data in this data frame. So we simply type counter. This is the name of our counter. And we want to use count, which we have imported here. We want to use that. And the start point is 0 and the step is 1. We want to start from 0 and the step is going to be 1 because we want to loop through. We want to count. We want to loop through on every index in this data frame. And you remember that the indices in Python starts at 0. So now, in order to make animated plots with Matplotlib and Python, it's time to define a function, for example, let's say call update, and we want to use that function in order to update our plots every interval. And we are going to define interval later, but every interval we want to update our chart. So we are going to define a function for that purpose. So we define a function, for example, let's say called update, which gets an argument called, let's say, for example, I or whatever you want, but I want to name it I. And it is going to be called every interval that we're going to define later. So every interval, we're going to call this function, which is update function, and we want to update our chart. So in order to get data from that data frame, we are going to use this counter, which we are going to loop through the indices of that data frame. So we simply type counter. We want to use counter, and we want the next element. We want the next element of this counter. This next command helps us in order to loop through on this counter. So it is going to count 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and etc. So it is going to loop through this counter. And the output, for example, we want to call the output IDX, for example, it stands for index in my mind. So as you can see, whenever we are updating our chart, we are using the next element of this counter in order to get another index of that of our data frame. So we simply type x.append because we want to append something to that x list. And the thing that we're going to append is the index, the corresponding index of that data frame and the zeroth column. Why? Because in our data, the zeroth column is x. And the other column with the index of 1 is y. So index 0 is x and index 1 is y. So here we can see that we are using the zeroth column, which is our x, and we are appending that to our x, which is our list. And here we are doing something similar, and we are appending to this y list, and we are appending something, and that thing is exactly the same as this one, but for example, not the zeroth column, but actually the column which is at index 1, which is our y. So after updating our x and y, we need to plot them. So first of all, we need to clear the axis. We simply type CLA for clearing the axis, and then we are going to plot something. We are going to plot x and y. We are going to plot our x and y. And after defining this function, in order to update our chart, we are going to use this func animation, which we have imported here. So we are going to use it. And if I press Control P on PyCharm, you can see that it says you should pass the figure. So our figure is called fig. And after that, we are going to pass the function that we want to update our chart with that function, which is update, which the name of that function is update. And remember, it shouldn't pass parentheses because the parenthesis is not part of the name of that function. The name of that function is update, not the parenthesis. And then we are going to pass the interval that we want to update our chart. For example, we want to update our chart every 200 milliseconds. And remember that this is millisecond, not second. This is millisecond. So after all, you want to store this kind of stuff in a variable. Let's say, for example, any or animation or whatever you want. And after all, we are going to simply type plt.show in order to show our plot. So if I run the code, you can see there it is. We have a animated plot. I really suggest you to watch this video as well. And please make sure to subscribe and click the bell next to it to be notified of every new video. Thank you.